Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Let's try it again.
This is Cool Kevin with the Huntington Beach Lowdown, giving you some general local knowledge and information about state and city beaches and anything else that has to do with Huntington Beach. This morning, we're going to cruise around Huntington Beach and check out the best breakfast spots. Don't worry about the weather, though. That's typical. It's called a marine layer, and it's usually between 6 and 8, burns off around 9 or 10, and it's absolutely beautiful after that. So don't let that stress you out. Enjoy breakfast.
At the end of the Huntington Beach Pier sits the iconic Ruby's Diner. Customers don't mind the walk, as it's the best place to watch the surfers catch their morning waves. Once inside the red and white building, beautiful panoramic ocean views grace nearly every table in the restaurant. It's definitely not uncommon to see a dolphin make an appearance while you're eating.
I think, actually, I'm going to have something right now. Let's see what we got going on. Okay, I would like to have a deluxe corned beef, eggs, and hash. Sounds delicious.
Voted one of the top three best breakfast places in Orange County on the 2011 OC Hot List is the Sugar Shack. Located smack dab in the center of Main Street since 1967, this place is truly a surf city legend. Tons of family portraits make this place feel like a home and not just a diner. With huge portions and low prices, it's no wonder this place is a favorite of locals and visitors alike.
Here at the Sugar Shack, how many professional surfers and who exactly has come through here?
It's been since the OP Pro started in the 80s. There's professional surfers always coming through here.
And all of them. Slater,
yeah.
Machado.
Oh yeah. Curran, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
Ryan, what is your favorite thing here at the Sugar Shack to eat on the menu?
Breakfast. Or can't go wrong with the omelets. Carlos been cooking here for 35 years.
I would have to say I would agree with that, and my favorite thing is the avocado bacon omelet. It's the best.
Continuing with family-run restaurants is the Breadcrumb Ohana Cafe, a Huntington Beach staple since 1983. Keep your eyes peeled, though, because this hidden gem is definitely under the radar. If you weren't looking for it, you'd probably drive right by. The locals are loyal to the Breadcrumb and are more than willing to pull some cash in order to eat there. That's right, this place is cash only. But no worries, they have an ATM if you forget.
I'm standing here with Brian, the owner of the Breadcrumb Cafe, and he's going to give us a little history of this great restaurant.
My dad started off more kind of a Jimmy Buffett kind of feel. He was the original SeaWorld trainer over in Texas. He started out with that kind of style, Jimmy Buffett, and then I've kind of gone into more of a kind of a relaxed feel Hawaiian breakfast place.
Here at the Breadcrumb, what would you say your favorite thing is?
I think probably the most popular thing would probably be the biscuits and gravy.
Okay, well, I'm trying their specialty dish here, biscuits and gravy. Let's see what's going on with this. Make sure I don't drop it. If you come to Huntington Beach, you'll have to get this. It's very delicious.
Adams Avenue Donuts isn't your ordinary quick breakfast stop. It's a Huntington Beach tradition. Not only do they have all your favorite donuts that Yelp users say would make Homer Simpson proud, but you can try unique types like a porcupine, butterfly, tiger tail, or even a maple bar with bacon.
How do the donuts compare to back home?
We usually eat Lamar's donuts, but these ones, I think they're better.
Well, that's good to know. So donuts in Huntington Beach are better than donuts in Nebraska. There you have it.
Adams Avenue Donuts is also famous for another reason. They have become the base camp for the donut derelicts. Starting every Saturday at 6:30 a.m., rain or shine, hot rods, street rods, classic and specialty creations from the South Bay to Laguna meet up at the Adams Avenue Donut Shop to create one of the biggest free classic car shows in Southern California.
pink. What is that? That's close enough to red. We're out of here.